best route to getting better returns on your investments generally in life, generally as a bigger corpus, is very simple. Start early, invest more. There is no denying that this is the best journey. However, other than investing more and investing for a longer period without touching it, man will do anything to improve his returns. He will watch TV, he will buy newsletters, he will do many, many, many things before he'll spend at least 10 years doing all this, and then come back and realize that saving more, or rather investing more and staying invested for a longer period, is the only sure way to success. In fact, the surest way to success has to be that. So a lot of young boys and girls start off with 3,000 rupees, 4,000 rupees SIPs. Maybe now it has gone up higher. And then they would increase it by 5% or 7% every year, because there is something called a top-up available. Now, when I'm talking of 3,000 rupees, I'm talking of, say, 20 years ago, when a lot of youngsters started doing SIP, maybe 15 years ago. Now the figures have changed, of course. There are people who are doing 5,000, there are people who are doing 25,000. So younger people have more cash and many of them are investing. However, what are things which people who do not invest do? Or what are the excuses that they give? First one will be, don't you think real estate will give me a better return? Now, this is a stupid question to be asking your financial advisor, because he does not know. If you want to invest in real estate and you think that will give you a better return, I'm not getting into, not at least not in this video, whether you should buy or invest, do that, right? They will neither invest in real estate nor will they invest in mutual funds. Their money will be sleeping in the savings bank account, but they will talk negatively about every industry and do nothing. Now, this feels very good to say, wow, this man knows everything about real estate, everything about equities, everything, but he does not know the basics of compounding. Start early, keep investing for a longer period. Those are the only keys to success. And then they will come and they'll ask you, oh, Subhra, I agree with you, 40 rupees per day is a good concept. But tell me, what will be the value of this money after 40 years or after 45 years? I got sick of answering this question. Whatever it is, it's going to be greater than zero. So bloody well start, right? So, and then the next question, how can you be sure that equities is the only thing which will work? What happens if something else works? That's fine, at least do it that. You have identified something else, right? You identified maybe oil, maybe platinum, maybe gold, I don't care what. But at least do that. People don't do that also, but they will keep talking for the rest of their life about how mutual funds are not so great, how it is expensive, etc. And why you shouldn't use an advisor, not use an advisor. They know everything. But other than investing, they will keep doing everything. And after 5-10 years, maybe they will regret saying, oh, I wish I had done this, right? And then asking the wrong people. They will go and ask their father. If their father has been working in the government for a long time, let's say income tax department or excise duty or whatever it used to be called earlier, now it's the GST, and ask him, Dad, should I invest in equities? And he will say, no, equities are very bad. I've met businessmen, blah, blah, blah. So again, asking the wrong people for the advice and then not being able to make up your mind because you asked them, that can again be disastrous. If your parents didn't know anything about equity, or they were late starters in equity and not a big fan of equity, then they are the wrong people to be asking, right? So same people who are willing to pay an EMI to buy a house will not put away that much money as in an SIP to build wealth. But they will. But if you get them I just wonder if you give them a equity loan, say somebody got an investment loan of 1 crore and he was forced to buy it, and then the EMI started after 3 years, he would be forced to invest that money, right? He would be forced, whatever he does, he has to do something about the money, and it would have been a leverage position. So he had to earn enough money to pay the interest and pay the EMI. I mean, EMI, which includes interest, but then seeing what happened, would he have invested better? Would he have invested more conservatively? One doesn't know all those things, right? Looking at investing is, I mean, somebody will be in your family who will say, oh, investing in equities is like gambling. The market can be in shambles. You can lose money. My uncle lost money. Keep away from all those negative people, because if you didn't do that, your mind can't be calm. If you see the previous video that I did, your mind has to be calm. Your mind has to be without any ripples. It has to be clean. It has to be clear. No negative thoughts. Only then can your mind work. You have to create that for your mind to work. If you don't create, your mind can't work. And when your mind can't work, you ask the wrong people. You get negative thoughts. You do all that. And you are unable to do even simple things like investing your money. Thank you.